Hello YouTube. Today I'm going to be uploading a new type of video. This one's going to be about coding. It's hopefully going to be a couple of lessons, not only one. This is basically just going to show you what you should download, how to download Geany, which is what you should use to be coding with. So I'll just quickly show you how you found it. You say Geany download. Click on the top link. Click on the setup. It's gonna take a little bit of time to download. While it downloads, let me note that Geany is only Windows. If you don't have Windows, I suggest you download something called Notepad++, which you can get on the Mac too. Just click on the download page, and then that will pop up this little guy, and it's gonna give you tons of download links if you want to download it. So anyways, I'm gonna open up this exe. Something popped up, so I click the yes. Click next, n next, 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 and install. If you want to change any one of those, it's fine, but this Geany installation won't install anything except the Geany and some Geany plugins, which help Geany. Anyways, finish. Now this is what it should look like. I'm gonna pin this. So if you use a Mac, then you would have Notepad++, which should look like this. I'll actually update this later. Anyways. So let me just show you in Geany, Notepad plus plus. People just do it in Notepad plus. Anyways, let me show you in Geany. So step one, you should have make note, which is made by those two symbols. Let me just zoom. So these two symbols make a note. I'm gonna put my name down. Tab. I'm gonna put down the date. Gonna put down the name of this code. So this is gonna be G. I'm gonna call it GenyTest.java. And then I'm gonna say what this code does. This code will test out G. Then I'm gonna close this comment off with these two symbols. I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna call it Geany test. You have to put the dot java at the end so it will know that it's saved as a dot java file. Then I'm gonna save it in, I have inside of my desktop something called java files. This. I'm going to save it inside of Java files in which I keep all my Java files. So I have them all in one spot. So I saved it. Now, by the way, compiling all this stuff, you need to have Java set up. If you don't know how to set up Java, watch one of the many videos online, which is what I use to set up Java. Just you should have Java installed, and you know that you installed it when you open the command. You c cd is ch cd. If you say Java, it should do this and show you all the possible usages of Java and Java C. We'll show you all the usages of Java C. So that will show you if you had. If you install Java. So, assuming that you install Java, you always want to open up with public class, which makes a new class that is public. Now, I'll get to that in a couple of lessons, but just call it public class. Now, this class has to be called the name of the file, so I have to call it public class Geany test without dot java, and then put this symbol. Now you want to save it. Now Geany test should become bold, which means that it's successfully made the class. Now you want to call make a method, which is called public class void main. Just copy down what I'm typing. And also a second thing. So what this does, oh, public static, not class. My fault. Public static void main. So this is called the main method. Each time you compile a code, it will find a class with the same name as the file, and then it will find inside of it a method, which is called public static void main, and with this stuff in parentheses. And it will execute it. So now in this, I'm gonna show you the most basic command. It's called system dot out dot print ln, and then you have to put up quotations and say hello. Close quotations and parentheses, and then make this semicolon. Then you want to close this main method off, close this class off, and then what I like to do is I like to click tab, make two slashes, and say outputs. So this is called a cont. While actually compiling, it won't copy down. It will skip this. This is just if someone else looks at the code, he knows what it does. So I would just leave a comment, which is kind of like this is all also comment. So if this compiles and they execute, it should output this text inside. So you could say anything inside. I'm just gonna output it. So I'm now inside of, it has you have to be inside of the same folder as the code. So let me just say to compile it you type Java C and Geany test dot Java. So this Java C line needs the dot Java at the end. Then the next line you say Java Geany test and doesn't have a dot Java at the end, and what it should do, it should compile, it should say anything you type inside. So if I say 1 2 + 2 = 5, it should, if I act type Java Geany test again, it won't change. What I have to do is to compile it again, Java C, and then if I act, whoop, my fault. Then if you type Java Geany test again, it will say the new text 2 + 2 = 5. Now, you don't need this actually, because I'm going to show you some cool stuff about this Geany. So let's say I want to change the text again and say, my name is, and then I want to put a tab. So make it go do a tab. You type backslash T, which is tab, and then I'll type inside my name. Then you have to go to the line. You'll see top that you'll see the symbol. It says compile. So what that does, it basically does the Java C command, and it should beep at the when successfully compiled. And then click on this, which will execute it. So my name is, as you can see, I did a tab, Ofagila. Click any key to keep continue, and then it would just quit, which is quite helpful in my opinion. The hotkey, it has some hotkey F8. F8 is a hotkey, and executing is F5. So compile F8, execute F5. So let me just see that.